Do subscribe to Ekeeda channel and press bell icon to get updates about latest engineering, HSE and IIT JEE main and advanced videos.
Hello friends, in the last lecture we have studied about eclipse and the staggered conformation, that is Newman's projection by Newman's projection as well as by Sauer's projection. So in that case, what we have got to know that the energy will be more, or that means the compound will be most unstable when the both the hydrogen will be very close to each other, because that would create the repulsion between the two hydrogen, and that's the reason the energy will go on increasing, and the energy between the two hydrogen molecules will increase, and that's the reason that will be unstable. But based on that also, we are now going to study about the torsional angles and the torsion energy, and what is that related to. Let us talk about that. So now, talking about torsional energy and torsion angle, so the torsional energy, talking about torsional energy and torsion angle, so talking about the first one, that is torsional energy, it means what? It is nothing but the energy required to rotate a molecule about carbon-carbon bond is known as torsional energy. So this is what we have taken an example in the previous lecture that we have did. So this was the one, that is, one is staggered and one is eclipse form. And in this case, we can rotate so as to convert the staggered form into eclipse form. But the energy, or vice versa, but the energy required to convert the staggered form to rotate to a particular angle, that kind of energy that is required is known as torsional energy. So the energy that is required to rotate the carbon-carbon bond, which is not mean viewed in this case, but when we comes to the Newman, that is Sauer's formula, that is Sauer's projection, so we could easily see the carbon and carbon bond in that case, and from that case also we could easily analyze that if the carbon is been the angle between, that is the carbon and carbon, or the rotation will take place on that axis, then in that manner the hydrogen and hydrogen bond angle, or we could say that the angle between this, will also change. But to rotate this carbon and carbon bond, we require a particular energy, and that kind of energy that has been required to rotate one of the carbon to make a particular angle, so that is known as torsional energy, that we have got to learn it in this thing. So now the next thing that we are going to do is basically torsional angle. So let us discuss about that also. So this is now what we are going to do with the torsional angle. So what does this means? It means that each hydrogen carbon carbon hydrogen unit in ethane that we know is characterized by the torsional angle. So which is the, and what is that, which is the angle between the two planes, that is HCC plane and CCH plane. So this is nothing but known as the torsional angle, or we could also say it as dihedral angle. So this can be easily shown in this case. This has been the diagram. So this is the plane where we could see that HCC, as you could see that it is the angle between the two planes, that is containing HCC plane and CCH plane. So this is what we can see, the HCC plane and CCH plane. So this is the different plane that we have, and this is the different plane that we have, that is CCH that we have. So in this case, basically the two angles, the two planes that we have, and this two planes will have a particular angle, and that angle is basically known as dihedral angle or torsional angle. So it is very easy to understand, and this could be easily seen in this case also, that is, but it could be very much easy when it comes to the Sauer's formula. So in this case also, as we could see that there would be a certain kind of angle between these two hydrogens, or these two planes, if we consider that this hydrogen is present in one plane while this hydrogen is present in another plane. So this will nothing but make a angle between them. So this angle is basically known as torsional angle. So that is what it explained in this, that is, it is the angle between the two planes, that is HCC plane. So as you could see, it is the angle between HCC plane and CCH plane. So that is of two different bond, of two different carbon atoms that we are talking about. So this will be the same thing that we will get to know. So let me explain it with the help of a Sauer's formula also, or Sauer's projection. So suppose this is the carbon that we had, and this is the bond angle that it, suppose if this is the carbon that we have, which will also have a hydrogen, as we could see here. So this will have HCC plane. So this will have a particular plane that we have, that is HCC, and the one which will have the other one, that is of this side, that is HCC. So the both will have different plane. They can have same plane also, but they can also have different plane. They will have the same plane when we are talking about eclipse form, but in a staggered form they will have two different planes, and that's the reason that we could see here that the angle between the C, that is this green line that represents the carbon itself, so CCH, it will make a particular angle, while this C and this H, that will make a particular angle with respect to each other, and the both the planes are different, and that angle is basically known as torsional angle. So that is what the torsional angle means. So let me tell you a few brief detail that what happens in eclipse. Actually, in eclipse the torsional angle is basically 0 degree in this case. And what happens if this hydrogen and this hydrogen are of 60 degree? So suppose if they are of the bond angle between them is basically 60 degree, then that would be called to be gauche. So that could be called as a gauche state, while this is basically the eclipse state. But there will be another one state. Suppose if this two hydrogens are being close to each other, and during rotation or during providing a torsional energy in such a manner that this edge will come down over here, that is in antiposition. So that kind of bond angle that it will make 180 bond angle, and that kind of state that it have converted from the initial eclipsed form to a form, another staggered form, but in this case the two hydrogens are opposite to each other, not in terms of eclipse but in terms of that is staggered form also. So therefore that will make the state to be called as anti-state, which will have a bond angle of torsional angle of basically 180 degree. So this is the thing. And talking about the stability, so this is the two example of ethane. So one is staggered form and one is eclipse form. So as you could see that these two hydrogens are close to each other, as well as they are facing towards each other, and this hydrogen are far away from each other, and they don't face each other, and in fact they will make a particular angle. So therefore this makes to be this ethane to be more unstable, and this is very stable. So therefore among 100, suppose if we compare, so 99% of the ethane that we obtain during chemical reaction or we obtain naturally are of the staggered form, while only 1% will be an eclipse form. So that makes the staggered form of the ethane to be more stable, because the energy is less, because it doesn't it is in fact more stable, and no torsional energy has been needed or no extra energy has been needed to rotate that thing, and that's the reason it is more stable when compared to the eclipse form. So this is what I wanted to explain about the torsional angle and the torsional energy. So thank you friends for watching this video. I hope you have understood this concept very clearly, and you will share this video with your friends also. So share this video, and yes, don't forget to subscribe Ekeeda channel. Thank you so much.